Good morning students, welcome to the next video lecture of data structure. In previous videos we have discussed about basic meaning of data, meaning of structure, what is data structure, which type of data structures are available, means primitive data structures and non-primitive data structures. Primitive data structures have different data types like integer, float, character, double, pointer and other side. Non-primitive data structure means user defined data structures like array, stack, queue, tree, graph, etc. So in our third lecture we are going to study about ADT. ADT is basically abstract data type. What is meaning of abstract? Abstract mean in short, which informations are hidden from us. Abstract data type is a triple, means A, D and 3. A means axioms, D means set of domains, and T, here we can use F, means set of functions. So ADT, which is only what is to be done is mentioned, but how it is to be done it's not mentioned, means it will be abstract for us. We can use it only, we can know its background. Okay, so ADT, all the implementation is hidden, hence it is called abstract. Abstraction, about this word you will study into next semesters, like OOP means if you study the C++, if you study Java programming, means if you study the object oriented programming languages, this abstract word will be there. Okay, so basically ADT is a type plus function name plus behavior of each function, and mainly the implementation of that ADT will be hidden from us. We can use it only. Here we have example of ADT. Our example is set. Here set can store the different type of integer values, and its functions will be store, retrieve and display. So what is the behavior of store function? So store function can store the integer value in a set. Second, retrieve function. So retrieve function can retrieve the desired element from the set. And third, display function. So display function will the display of all content of the set. Okay, so next thing is algorithm. This algorithm we have already studied into C programming language. The basic definition of algorithm is, an algorithm is a finite set of instructions for the performing a particular task, or we can say it formally, algorithm is a step by step solution of any problem. Basically step by step of any problem solving is called algorithm. We have already discussed an example of our algorithm in first semester. We have discussed about a process of tea making, means if we don't know how to make a tea, then that is a problem for us. If we are making tea step by step, so that solution, step by step solution, will be known as an algorithm for us. Okay, so here we have an example of adding two numbers. So step one, always step one will be a start. Step two, read the first number is variable a, means getting the value of a variable. Third step, read the second number is variable b, means retrieving value of b variable. Next step is perform the addition of both the numbers and store in variable c, means c is equal to a plus b process. Next step is print the value of variable c as a result, means after calculating c is equal to a plus b, we have to just print c. And next step, last step is stop. So basically our problem was the addition of two numbers. Step by step we have added two numbers and get the addition of two numbers. So our problem is solved by step. So this is called algorithm. Next, properties of an algorithm. First, finiteness. It should terminate after a finite number of steps. This is very essential thing for any algorithm. Means algorithm must stop after any number of your steps. Means it should be finite. Means after 30, after 40, after 50 step, algorithm will stop. So algorithm will be finite. Next, definiteness. Each instruction should be clear and unambiguous. Unambiguous means clear. Each instruction, after reading that instructions, we can know that this step is want to say these things. Means no any ambiguity can be in it. Next thing is input. Each algorithm is supplied with zero or more external quantities. Means algorithm can have zero number of input or more number of inputs in it. If we are printing a simple hello world, then that algorithm will not have any input. But next thing is output. It produces at least one output. Any algorithm have to produce at least one output. So these are the properties of an algorithm: finiteness, definiteness, input, and output. Next one is effectiveness. Every instruction must be sufficiently basic that it can in principle be carried out by a person, and it should be feasible, should be written in simple English, and should provide the correct solution. Means if you want to find solution of any problem, then that solution will be effective into form of algorithm. If you write an algorithm, then every step must be understandable by the learner of that algorithm. In many cases, it can happen that only writer of that algorithm can understand that algorithm, but other cannot understand that algorithm. So this is not effectiveness of that algorithm. Effectiveness of algorithm is every person who are reading that algorithm can know each and every step of that solution of algorithm. So this is effectiveness. Next is performance analysis and measurement. The efficiency of an algorithm can be decided by measuring the performance of an algorithm. Performance and algorithm will be considered by two things. First one is time and second one is storage. Time. So amount of time required by an algorithm to execute. Second, storage. So amount of storage required by an algorithm. means time will be very short for any algorithm, and storage will be also short for the algorithm. If we required more time, that is not effective. If we required more storage, then that is not effective. So these two things, time and storage, are the performance analysis measurement for any algorithm. We will know what are the cases for this performance analysis measurement in another video. So this is it for today's video lecture. We have studied in video lecture what is ADT, what is full form of ADT, what is algorithm, how we can write algorithm, what are the properties of algorithm, and what are performance analysis measurement of an algorithm. Okay, so this is it for this video lecture. Thank you, students.